Martin Luther said, "For in the true nature of things, if you rightly consider, every green tree is far more glorious than if it were made of gold and silver. Spring trees are one of the fabulous creatures around us. The leaves stay connected with each other through tree branches to get enough nutrients and water. In autumn, the leaves change color and they lose their connection with the branches and fall down. But eventually, they regrow again and the tree is full and green again. A healthy brain looks like a tree in spring with lots of branches called axons extending between brain cells or neurons. These axons help the cells to communicate and stay alive. However, the brain of Alzheimer's disease patients looks a little bit like a tree in autumn with shriveled branches and leaf connections beginning to be lost. Neurons, like autumn leaves, are lost to the vine forever. And when the patients lose those cells, they also lose their beautiful memories, cognition, and emotional stability. The aim of my PhD project is to develop a drug that will help an Alzheimer's disease patient to regenerate neural connections, helping the brain to flourish and regrow like this tree in spring. We estimate that by 2050, more than 100 million people will be affected by Alzheimer's disease, and there is currently no known cure for this disease, but we do think we know what causes it. We are now pretty sure that Alzheimer's disease is caused by the accumulation of a protein in the brain called beta amyloid. Beta amyloid is a normal protein, but when there are too many of these proteins, they form clumps that deposit outside the neurons. My research uses brain samples from Alzheimer's disease patients to show that beta amyloid can alter the function of a protein called CRMP2. CRMP2 is important for the growth of neurons' axons. If there is a problem with CRMP2 protein, as happens in Alzheimer's disease, the axons cannot grow. Without a functional axon to communicate with other cells, the cells eventually die. And this cell is centered in the areas that control memory and cognition, called the hippocampus. My work shows that under normal conditions, beta amyloid can activate an enzyme that modifies CRMP2 protein in a certain way. And every time this happens, it makes the axon contract, a bit like a snail pulling in its antenna. In healthy cells, the axon expands again towards important sites on adjacent neurons. But in Alzheimer's disease, beta amyloid keeps activating this enzyme, locking the axon in a state of perpetual contraction. My work shows that it's possible to block this particular effect on CRMP2, so the beta amyloid key can no longer fit inside. And amazingly, this has preserved the axons of beta amyloid affected neurons or Alzheimer's disease affected neurons. If all goes according to plan, my findings will be used in medications that will actually begin to reverse the effect of Alzheimer's disease, literally degrowing people's memories, so their brains can again be like a beautiful green tree in spring. Thank you.